Squarespace has a built-in scrolling block, and we may even add wave intensity to it. However, when we try to add a background color, the background color doesn't follow the wave path. In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to add this wavy scrolling block with background colors using CSS. This technique will allow us to adapt to any wave path or block colors. To access the code that I'll be referencing throughout the video, please check out the link in the description box. You'll be asked to create an account and join our mailing list such that you'll be updated about our future resources. We may add a scrolling block to any Squarespace blank section. In this particular example, I just added a background image. We double-click the block to access the block settings. And under content, this is where we change the text. We may also add emojis or other characters. And right under design, this is where we can add the wave intensity. There are other settings which we may configure here. For example, the speed as well as the option to pause and hover. For the text size, I prefer using the medium option or the large one to make it more prominent. Now, the key for us to add a background color is to duplicate this block and assign a background color to the duplicated block. For example, if I hit Command D, it will automatically duplicate this block. You may also use this icon to duplicate. And then for this duplicated block, I will assign a background color. If I scroll down, there is this option to toggle on this background color. I will choose a color that's different from the first marquee or scrolling block. So I will change it to this blue color and hit save. For this duplicated block, make sure that this fade edges option is toggled off. Now you may refer to our resource entry, and under wavy scrolling block, we may add the CSS. So just copy this set of CSS and then switch back to our site. To access the CSS, simply hit the forward slash via your keyboard and then start typing custom CSS. This is where we'll paste the code, and notice how it hides the second scrolling text, but it retains the background color. Note that you might need to refresh your page for this change to be reflected. And whilst we're on edit mode, the background color might not show up as expected, but it's best to check it out of edit mode. If you wish to change the color of our scrolling text, you may again refer to our code entry, and under optional CSS, you'll find this option to change the marquee color. Simply copy this and go to our CSS and paste this code. And since we're using the fluid editor, it's easy for us to overlap our blocks. And for us to achieve our demo layout, we just need to make sure that these blocks are completely aligned. So let's just move our background block and make sure that it is positioned beneath our scrolling text by using this option to move backward. We may also use our keyboard shortcut shift arrow down. At the moment, their sizes are not aligned, so I'll just make sure that they have the same size. And this way, we're able to create this wavy marquee with background color. In our code entry, you'll also find an option to change the background color width. So if I copy this code and paste this to our custom CSS panel, you'll find that if I try changing the stroke width, for example, to 1.8mm, then the background path becomes larger. So this is just an optional customization. Now, what if we'd like to achieve this layout wherein it seems like our wavy marquee serves as a section divider? I was able to achieve this just by using the same section, but I added a shape block at the bottom. To achieve this, our first step is to make sure that the fill screen option is toggled off. This way, we're able to make sure that the fluid grid spans the entire height, and then we can add a shape block at the bottom. I'll add a shape block at the bottom right here and just make sure that it spans the entire width of the section. So I'm just making sure I'm dragging the shape to the right edge. When we're using shape blocks, note that we have the flexibility to change our color to any of our palette colors or to assign a custom one. Now, our next step is to manage the stacking of our shape block. To do so, initially, we'd like it to cover our scrolling blocks. And from here, we manage its stacking by moving it backward. We may use this icon to move backward or use our keyboard shortcut shift arrow down. So I am pressing this until it's disabled. And now it's underneath both our scrolling blocks. Now that we're sure that it's underneath both of our scrolling blocks, we can now position it at the bottom so we can manage its height such that it won't peek through the top of the wave. Now I can save this, and as soon as I click out of edit mode, we're now able to achieve something similar to our demo layout. And from here, we're able to add any other components like text block and add it to this section such that it seems like we're using the Wavy marquee as our section divider. Once we add our text, note that we have the flexibility to change the color of our text and also to make it scale to the width of the container. Now we need to manage how our blocks are positioned on mobile. To do that, we click this option to switch to mobile view. And again, we just need to make sure that our Wavy marquee are completely aligned and that our scrolling text is tacked on top of our background path. So I'm using again this icon to move forward. Then I can also select multiple blocks and move them at the same time. So I'm also gonna do the same thing for our shape block and make sure it is underneath both the scrolling text blocks and also move our text as well as manage the height of our section. As soon as we're out of edit mode, we're able to achieve this effect on mobile. If you use this technique, please tag us on Instagram using our handle at SquareStylist. We'd love to see what you create. And if you need personalized support in your projects, we're not able to provide that via the comment section below, but we provide that in our program Standout Squarespace. Aside from high-touch support, we also have a lot more workshops inside the Standout Squarespace program, including scroll-based animations, and we have resources to help you deliver high-quality web design projects that meet web design standards on responsiveness, accessibility, and SEO. And if you are a web designer working on Shopify projects too, you may check out our video about adding this Wavy marquee feature to any Shopify theme.